Hi friends, welcome to a new learning video on Pharmaguideline. In this video, we will discuss how to write a validation master plan. A validation master plan, VMP, is a crucial document in the pharmaceutical industry that outlines the strategy and approach for validation activities within a facility. It serves as a roadmap for ensuring that all processes, systems, and equipment meet regulatory requirements and maintain the integrity and quality of pharmaceutical products. In this video, we will provide a step-by-step guide on how to write a validation master plan, covering the key components and considerations. The first and very initial step is to understand regulatory requirements. Begin by thoroughly understanding the regulatory requirements specific to your geographical location, such as those outlined by the FDA, EMA, or other relevant authorities. Familiarize yourself with the applicable guidelines, standards, and expectations to ensure compliance throughout the validation process. The second step is to define scope and objectives. Clearly define the scope and objectives of the validation master plan. Identify the systems, processes, and equipment that require validation, taking into account their impact on product quality, patient safety, and regulatory compliance. Determine the boundaries and limitations of the plan to provide a clear focus. In third step, establish validation policies and procedures. Develop comprehensive validation policies and procedures that align with regulatory requirements and industry best practices. These should include guidelines on document control, change management, risk assessment, deviation management, and other key aspects of the validation process. Ensure consistency and clarity in the documentation to facilitate understanding and implementation. Fourth step is to identify validation activities. Identify the specific validation activities that need to be conducted for each system, process, or equipment. This may include equipment qualification, process validation, cleaning validation, analytical method validation, and others as applicable. Define the sequence and timeline for these activities, taking into account dependencies and resource availability. The fifth step is to perform risk assessment. Perform a risk assessment for each validation activity to identify critical parameters, potential hazards, and associated risks. Use tools such as failure mode and effects analysis, FMEA, or hazard analysis and critical control points, HACCP, to systematically assess risks and prioritize validation efforts. Document the risk assessment process and outcomes. The sixth step is to develop validation protocols. Develop detailed validation protocols for each validation activity, outlining the specific procedures, acceptance criteria, sampling plans, and test methods to be used. Ensure that the protocols are scientifically sound, comprehensive, and aligned with regulatory expectations. Include provisions for deviations, investigations, and revalidation if necessary. Seventh step is to define the roles and responsibilities. Define the roles and responsibilities of individuals involved in the validation process. This includes the validation team, subject matter experts, quality assurance personnel, and other stakeholders. Clarify their responsibilities, authorities, and communication channels to ensure effective coordination and accountability. The eighth step is documentation and reporting. Establish clear guidelines for documenting and reporting validation activities. Define the format, content, and retention period for validation documents, such as protocols, reports, and records. Ensure proper version control, signature approvals, and traceability. Emphasize the importance of accurate and timely documentation to maintain compliance and support audits. The ninth step is change control. Implement a robust change control process to manage any modifications to validated systems, processes, or equipment. Clearly define the criteria for initiating and evaluating changes, and establish procedures for impact assessment, risk analysis, and revalidation if necessary. Ensure that changes are properly documented, approved, and communicated to all relevant stakeholders. The tenth step is periodic review and revalidation. Include provisions for periodic review and revalidation of validated systems, processes, or equipment. Establish a schedule for conducting regular reviews to assess ongoing compliance and identify any necessary updates or improvements. Determine the triggers for revalidation, such as significant process changes, equipment replacement, or regulatory requirements. Writing a validation master plan is a critical step in ensuring that validation activities in the pharmaceutical industry are conducted efficiently and in accordance with regulatory expectations. By following this comprehensive guide, you can develop a robust and compliant validation master plan that outlines the strategy, approach, and requirements for validation activities within your facility. Remember to regularly review and update the plan to accommodate changes and improvements in technology, regulations, and industry practices. Like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular updates. Thanks for watching this video.